Welcome. In this video, we'll look at some of the areas we can apply billing profiles in DrChrono.
To begin, we'll go to the schedule in DrChrono and open up an appointment window.
And then I'll navigate up to the billing tab. From here, I've got a drop-down menu of all the billing profiles I have in my account. I can go ahead and select one, and the codes will be applied here. I'll scroll down and click Save. How billing profiles are created and how they can be attached to appointment profiles is addressed in another video in our EHR Setup and Appointment Scheduling series. Next, we'll look at adding a billing profile from the clinical note. I'll go down here and click View Clinical Note. And then once the clinical note is open, I'm going to go to the Billing tab here under the H&P or SOAP. Then I'll go to my Billing Profiles menu and select the billing profile I would like. I'm going to select Strep again. It'll ask me if I want to apply this profile. I'll click OK. And I can see that the codes have been applied to the visit. And if you need to make any adjustments to the codes, you can do that here as well. We can also apply billing profile in the Live Claims feed. To get to the Live Claims feed, we go to Billing and Live Claims feed. And once you're here, you can click on a data service to open up the billing details screen. After the billing details screen has loaded for this date of service, we can scroll down and see the codes that we have. I'll select a billing profile from the drop-down menu. I'm going to select Strep again. Then next, I'm going to scroll down, and in the lower right, I'm going to click the blue Verify and Save button. It'll take just a few seconds here for the page to load. And once it has, the codes will be applied to the visit. If you make any further changes to the codes in this screen, just click Verify and Save again. We can also add a billing profile to a switch in the Form Builder. To get to the Form Builder, we go to Clinical and Form Builder. And then here we open a form. And then I'll go over and add a switch to this form. And then I'll click on the pencil to edit. Next, I'm going to call this one Strep. If I want to add any text to the generated text, I can. And then I'll select the billing profile from the menu here. You can search or select it from the dropdown. After selecting the profile, click Update Field and save your form. And then go to a clinical note. In the clinical note, I'll select the template that has my billing profile attached to a switch. I'll activate the switch. And then I can go to the H&P or SOAP tab and go to the billing section. And I can see the codes that have been applied to the appointment. And again, you could make further changes here if needed. On the EHR app, we can also use the billing profiles. I'm going to click Start Visit here to launch a visit. And then I'll select the billing area. And then I'll click on Billing Profile just to make sure that's selected. It should be by default. I'll click on the plus. Then I'm going to select the billing profile that I'd like to use. Once that's been applied, you're all set. Just like the web version of DrChrono, we can activate a switch to apply our billing profile. Once that's set, we can go to the billing section under H&P or SOAP and see the codes that have been applied. You can also see the results of applying a billing profile by going to the main appointment screen, tapping on Superbill, and a PDF itemized receipt will appear with the codes applied. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video.